6 water. Children, the 6th lesson in the course book is water, and now we will do the workbook part for this lesson, water. Exercise time. The first bit here is tick the correct answer. Here we have 3 incomplete sentences. We have to complete these sentences by choosing the correct answer from these given options and by ticking the correct answer box here. 1. Plants need water to dash. And here given options are A. Bathe, B. Wash clothes, C. Make food. So here the correct answer is make food. We will put the tick mark here for the option C. Make food. Plants need water to make food. 2. We need water for dash. The options are A. Drinking, B. Bathing, C. Both A and B. So here the correct answer is option C. Both A and B. Drinking and bathing. So we will put the tick mark here for option C. We need water for both A and B, that is drinking and bathing. 3. We can save water by, the options are A. Keeping the tap closed while brushing teeth, B. Bathing with shower. Among these two options, the correct answer is option A. We will put the tick mark here for the option A. We can save water by keeping the tap closed while brushing teeth. So this is about the first bit. And now we will move to the second bit. The second bit under exercise time is fill in the blanks. Here we have 4 fill in the blank sentences. We have to write the correct word in this blank and complete the sentence. 1. We should always drink dash water. And the correct answer for this is clean. We should always drink clean water. 2. Rain water collects in ponds and dash. And the correct answer is lakes. Rain water collects in ponds and lakes. 3. Plants need dash to make food. The correct answer here is water. Plants need water to make food. 4. Water is used to dash clothes. And the correct word here is wash. Water is used to wash clothes. So children, these are the completed sentences. 1. We should always drink clean water. 2. Rainwater collects in ponds and lakes. 3. Plants need water to make food. 4. Water is used to wash clothes. So this is about the second bit. And now we will move to the third bit. 3. Encircle the odd one. Children, here we have 3 groups and in each group we have 4 different words. And among these 4 words, we have to circle the odd one. The different word we have to circle, which is different from the other words. The one word which is different from the other words, we have to put a circle on that word. 1. In the first group, what are the words here? Bottle, jug, pond, glass. Children, bottle, jug and glass we use in our home to drink water, and these are utensils. And pond, it is a source of water. It is a source of water where we find in the land the water accumulates in a pond. So bottle, jug and glass are utensils. So we will circle the word pond as the odd one. Two, the words are well, hand pump, tube well, puddle. So among these four words, puddle is the odd one. We will circle puddle. Three, drink, cook, wash, walk. So among these four words, can you identify the odd one? Yes, walk is the odd one here. Why? Because drinking, cooking, washing needs water, and for walking we don't need water. So this is completely different word from drink, cook and wash. So we will circle the word walk here. So children, we have circled the odd one from each group. In the first group, we have circled pond. Why? Because bottle, jug and glass are the utensils we use at home, and the pond is a source of water where large amount of water is located. And in the second group, we have well, hand pump, tube well, puddle. And we have circled puddle because puddle is the one, it is a small pool of liquid or water or a rainwater on the surface of the earth. And well, hand pump and tube well, these are the sources of water from the under the earth. We get water from well, and hand pump also we get water from the underground. Tube well also we get water from the underground. And three, we have circled walk. Why? Because drink, cook and wash. These three words and the actions require water, but walk does not require water. So this is an odd one. We have circled walk here. So with this we completed the third bit. And now we will move to the next bit. The next bit is number 4. Let's answer. Here we have 3 questions. We will read the questions and write the answers for these questions. 1. Write 2 ways to save water. And the answer, we can save water by closing the taps after use. B. Not wasting water while bathing. So children, here we have to write 2 ways to save water. And what are those 2 ways? A. Closing the taps after use, and the second way is B. Not wasting water while bathing. By these 2 ways we can save water. Second question, how can we keep water clean? The answer, we can keep water clean if we do not allow drains to flow into rivers. B. Do not bath and wash clothes in ponds and river. C. Do not throw garbage and leftovers on sources of clean water. So how can we keep water clean? By not allowing drains to flow into rivers, and we should not wash clothes in ponds or rivers. And C, the third way is we should not throw garbage or any leftovers on sources of clean water. 3. Give 3 sources of water. The answer is rain, rivers, ponds and lakes are the sources of water. So these are the answers for the given questions. First is write 2 ways to save water. Answer, we can save water by A. Closing the taps after use. B. Not wasting water while bathing. 2. How can we keep water clean? We can keep water clean if we do not allow drains to flow into rivers. B. Do not bath and wash clothes in ponds and river. And C. Do not throw garbage and leftovers on sources of clean water. And the third question is, give three sources of water. The answer, rain, rivers, ponds, lakes are the sources of water. And this is about the fourth bit under exercise time. And now we will move to the next bit. The next section here is, let's do it. Children, the next section is, let's do it. What is the activity? Find the sources of water in the word grid. Yes, this is a word grid. And we have to find the sources of water in the word grid. In this word grid, we have to find the sources of water. And we can take the help of these pictures. These pictures are of the sources of water. So, this can be pond, lake, river, and this is well, rain, sea. So, these are the sources of water. We will find these names in this given word grid. First, we will find pond. P-O-N-D, pond. We will color this name. P-O-N-D, pond. Lake. L-A-K-E, lake. We will color this word lake. L-A-K-E, lake. Then we have river. We will color the word river. R-I-V-E-R, river. And next we have rain. We will color the word rain. R-A-I-N, rain. R-A-I-N, rain. And next we have sea. S-E-A-C. We will color the word sea. So, children, now we have found out the sources of water in this word grid. These are pond, river, lake, sea, rain, and we have one more, well, W-E-L-L, well. We will color well here, W-E-L-L, well. So, we have got pond, lake, river, well, rain, and sea, S-E-A-C. So, with this we completed the let's do it section. And with this we also completed the workbook part for the lesson water.